Hey, my name is Jay. I don't normally do this on-camera business, so just bear with me. Today, I will be on camera though, and the reason for that is that a good buddy of mine, Dave, has issued me a sample challenge and it sounded like a lot of fun. So today we're gonna be using some samples. I've never heard them before, and we're gonna make an entire song from scratch. A record from 1973 by a band called Baltic. Never heard it before. I was gonna try to do it with all on one device, but I chickened out at the last minute. And so for some of the heavy lifting in the first steps, we're gonna use this, the MPC One. Fair warning, I've hardly used this before. And then to actually do the performance itself and to put together a final track, I imagine we'll use this, the Elektron Octatrack MkII. This thing is maybe my favorite piece of hardware. I think it is my favorite piece of hardware. It's so performative and expressive and musical. So we're gonna put together the final track on this. I'm actually using this video to announce that I'll be starting a Patreon. Just stick around to the end and we'll talk more about it then. But the very first step is, of course, to listen to the songs, so let's do that now. So I've just loaded up a brand new track. Let's assign just a sample here so we can hear it and then start to clip it down if we hear anything we like. Let's see what it's like. On to track two. And I'll just hit the chop button every time I hear something potentially interesting. That's kind of cool. All right, on to track three. Cause I think I need a woman to love and take care of me. Oh, Dave. Okay, let's try track four. Oh yeah. No, that's major key business. Don't they know I'm pathetic? I don't think this has anything. Any Canadians here? That one part there really reminds me of Sleep Country Canada. Oh, that's good. Okay. I take it back. I take it back, Baltic. This section's great. See if there's another chord or something. Why buy a mattress anywhere else? Let's take a look at track five. Song number six. So good. Oh, that's great. Wow. Track six, you are a real winner. Okay, let's see what track seven holds for us. Lonely nights in cities bright. I'm sitting all alone. Let's just keep going. I wonder if this was the drummer song. Dave. There's nothing on this track, Dave. How about song nine? Let's see. All right, on to our final track. Oh yeah. Cool. Got some drums. All right, what else we got? Yeah, love a long weekend. Love it. Okay, so we've been through the whole album. We've got more than enough samples to work with. Dave was walking home one night and accidentally called his home and left a, what do they call that? A butt dial. He left a voice message of his footsteps. And he really liked the sound of that rhythm and challenged me to somehow include that walking type sound in the song itself. Let's see what we can make out of that. It's got some rhythm to it. I hear you, Dave. Oh. There we go. Is he saying no? I took all of the individual slices I made, I laid them out on a drum program, and started goofing around to see if I could find something. The very first thing I came up with, it had a cool kind of hip hop vibe to it, but it wasn't, I couldn't see how I was gonna sustain it into a whole song. Took a bit of time off, came back and looked at it again, and I'm happier with where we are now, so let's listen to that. So here's where we got it set up. It's mainly revolving around this one loop. And if we look at this, we'll see that I've actually got it running through a high-pass filter just to sort of take out some of that bass material. It means I'll be able to play along and track some sort of more interesting chord progression later on. Yeah, I don't know why this line in particular stuck with me, but it really did, so I just grabbed it and again bandpass filtered it to take out both the higher and lower stuff just so that it's mainly just a voice. And then I've got this other one. Which actually isn't fully in tune with the thing that I'm recording, but most of the notes are. So I'm hoping the other ones slip into the mix, or I'll just use the Octatrack to trim out what doesn't work. And here I've, again, high-passed it, and with this one I've also added in some compression and delay just to make it a little more even and also to give it some stereo feel. And then on the drum track, so if we go there, so we've just got our regular drums, you know, cut up into samples. I wish I'd found a place for that. I've done a couple things here. One, I took the kick, and again, if you look at the, you can see I've used a low pass filter to take out some of the sound. I've also, if we go back to the main page here, done some work with the channel strip just to sort of boost the low end and get more of a thump out of the kick. Similarly, if we go to our hi-hats, this isn't actually a hi-hat. This is actually a kick drum, but I just filtered out all of the low-end content, so now I have a nice, easy kit to work with. Then I also had a second snare. So what I did for this one was just roll off some of the high-end so it sounds like a roll. So it's just a little bit of variation and sort of makes it sit back in the mix a little bit more. So altogether, I took these two drum programs and now I have this. So I got lots and lots to work with here. This is a great starting point. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to output the drums, the drum track as a loop, and then work with it as a loop on the Octatrack, because I just find that to be more fun. So our next step really is now to export everything and get it onto the Octatrack so we can start to build a song proper instead of just a constant repeating loop. I just turned everything off, and then I realized that I haven't done anything with that weird sample of Dave's phone call to himself. Well, I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna chop up this whole thing. Okay, sure. Okay, so everything's on the octa now. The next question is making a song out of it. So I spent a little bit of time this afternoon playing some guitar to the music and seeing if I could come up with a chord progression I liked. And now that I have a chord progression, the next step is really to figure out how to make it come alive within the Octatrack. I've currently got two tracks that are free that aren't doing anything. And I know it's a bit of cheating, sorry Dave, but I decided why not add some synths. So the two synths I'm going to add are, one, the Black Corporation Deckard Stream, love this thing. And two, I need a bass. I need something super solid and just no nonsense, big bottom end. And so of course the Minitaur it is. So one thing I really like about the Octatrack's arpeggiator is that when you set it to something less than 16 steps and then you start to mute out notes, you get some really, really interesting rhythmic variations. Okay, so composition's going well. Deckard's has two parts. I have this rhythm part and a lead on top. Thinned out the butt dial just a little bit. I think I might use that as the build-up breakdown sound. So it needs some weirdness, so I'll probably add that on the drums first before I start thinking about the scenes. So I've added another pattern. It's a complete duplicate, or it started as a complete duplicate. Then what I did was I took the drums and I started chopping them up into pieces. On its own, it sounds something like this. Which is fine. It's kind of a cool halftime thing, but it sounds too reminiscent of what we had before. But if you take the same thing, close down the envelopes quite a bit, then you start to get this weird rhythm that's going along with where the slices are. So we can see this. And that's starting to get cool. And then if we take it a little bit further, add some sample rate reduction, add some bit rate reduction, and we're into some really interesting territory. And so now we've actually got a bridge or a B section here, which was kind of by accident. The next step is really to start developing and building some scenes. So I use scenes on the Octatrack for two main reasons. The first one is that it allows for transitions, so transitioning throughout an intro or on your way out of a song. And usually I put those transitional scenes over on this side. And then you also have your, I don't know, your scenes that are about spice or flavor. Those are weird, glitchy sort of pieces or weird parts where the EQ or delay or something just goes wild. And I usually keep those in the second half here. So there's no magic recipe to how I make my scenes. This is a real trial and error process, and the goal is always to sort of go as wild and weird as I possibly can. I wonder about backwards. Oh, that sounds awesome. So with setting the scenes, it's really easy. You just hold the button. So I'm on scene two here. I'm going to turn this until I get to my reverse. And now, so I felt like the drums needed a little bit more during the breakdown section. So I actually added some re-triggers to them, as you can see here, and it leads to this. Subtle difference, but it sounds cool. Now what's really neat is that these re-triggers still sound kind of cool when you switch over, and I think I'm gonna clean it up so you can hear. I've created a scene here where the envelope is much, much shorter, so it closes off much quicker, and I've also decreased the reverb time and increased the reverb mix, and also created some weird noisiness so that you can transform this sound into this really rhythmic or really percussive sound. Pretty cool. I really like it. So I also added the Strymon Ola, which is a stereo vibrato, and the Deckard's Dream's going through that to give it a little more stereo space. So that's just the wildness vocal reversed and slowed down by half. So I love this master level delay that cuts out the clean signal and just leaves the delay tails. Okay, so at this point I have, let's see, five sort of spicy scenes, and I've also got a bunch of transition scenes over here, four or five transition scenes. So I basically have all the workings of the song now. Now the goal is to catch a performance of it. Without further ado, here's the final product of all this work.
All right.
So that's it, that's the song. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you've enjoyed this walkthrough workflow type video. I don't normally do these. It's been a lot of fun, but also quite challenging. Just a last sort of note on support. If you want to support me, you can of course keep watching these videos, and I really appreciate it. You can buy my albums on Bandcamp, and again, for all the people who've been buying them, I really, really appreciate the support. Thank you. And then finally, like I mentioned, I'm starting a Patreon. And the idea of the Patreon is really to address the number one requests and comments that I get in these videos, specifically to spend more time on workflow and walkthrough. So every month, if not a couple times a month, I will sit down, either do a deep dive on a piece of gear, maybe look at hardware connectivity, how to build scenes on the Octatrack, whatever works for the people who support me on Patreon, really. So I'll be checking in regularly about that. It will also provide songs, the actual audio recordings for anyone. I often get people who want the songs. I usually like to wait until there's a cohesive record, so I'm going to just hand out the songs to all Patreon supporters, and of course when the albums come out on Bandcamp, I'll send you a release code so you can have a nice tidy version of it. And then finally, it's an opportunity to chat with me. I'll have a Discord server, you can make requests for videos, you can ask me about specific aspects of a performance, you can challenge me in all sorts of fun and interesting ways. So yeah, please do consider supporting me on Patreon. It would mean the world. I'd love to work a little bit less and to spend a little more time working on music. So thanks for your time, and as always, thanks for your indulgence. Take care.